अज्ञातिमिदंधस्य ज्ञानांजनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतः पदकमलम् श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातां सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादां सहगणा ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितंश्च। नमो ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीति नामने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात देशतारिणे वंच कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यो च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामो हरे राम 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 हरे। हरे कृष्णा। सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑल फॉर आवर हरि नाम चिंतामणि क्लास। So till now we have completed the prologue, the preface, the foreword of the book, the introduction of the book. So today we are going to begin from chapter 1, the first chapter of this book. So chapter 1 is called The Glories of the Holy Name, Shri Naam Mahatmya Suchan. This is The Glories of the Holy Name. Gadai Gauranga Jaya Janava Jeevan सीता अद्वैत जय श्रीवासादि भक्तगण। ग्लोरी टू लॉर्ड चैतन्य टू लॉर्ड गदाधर एंड टू नित्यानंद द लाइफ ऑफ जानवा देवी जय जानवा जीवन। सो बेसिकली द कॉन्सर्ट ऑफ नित्यानंद हूज जानवा देवी। सो भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर इज ऑफरिंग ओबेसेंसेस टू एवरीवन। सीता अद्वैत जय श्रीवासादि भक्तगण। ग्लोरी टू अद्वैत the husband of Sita Thakurani. Glory to Srivas and all the devotees of the Lord. So here we are getting to know a lot of the associates of Lord Chaitanya also. So the wife of Nityananda, her name is Janava Devi. The wife of Advaita Acharya, her name is Sita Thakurani. Lavana Jaladi Tire Neela Chale Shri Mandire दारु ब्रह्म पुरुष प्रधान जीवे निस्तारिते हरि अर्चा रूपे अवतारी भोग मोक्ष करेन प्रदान। ऑन द शोर ऑफ द सॉल्ट वाटर ओशन इन नीलाचल लवन जलधि तीरे दैट मीन्स ऑन द शोर ऑफ द सॉल्ट ओशन नीलाचले श्री मंदिरे इन नीलाचल इन द ब्यूटिफुल टेम्पल दारु ब्रह्म पुरुष प्रधान दैट सुप्रीम लॉर्ड ब्रह्म that Purusha Pradhan resides as a Daru. Daru means as a wooden deity. The Supreme Personality of Godhead descended to this world and assumed the form of a wooden deity. So why has the Lord come in the form of Jagannath? Boga Moksha Karena Pradhan. So that he can give the conditioned souls Boga, enjoyment and liberation, happiness and liberation. Sei Dhamme Shri Chaitanya मानवे करिते धन्य सन्यासी रूपेत भगवान कलीते ये युग धर्म बुजाहिते तार मर्म काशी मिश्र घरे अधिष्ठान। सो इन दिस होली अबोर्ड ऑफ जगन्नाथपुरी where that supreme lord resides as Lord Jagannath in the form of this wooden deity. In that same abode, in this holy abode, Saitame Shri Chaitanya. In that same holy abode, Lord Chaitanya also is there. Manave Karite Dhanya. So the Lord has taken avatar as Lord Chaitanya to bless the human race. Manave Karite Dhanya. To make them very fortunate. Sanyasi Rupete Bhagavan. So the same Supreme Lord, in one way he has come in the form of Jagannath, in the form of this wooden deity, Daru Brahma. And here he has come as Lord Chaitanya and he has accepted sannyas. Sanyasi Rupete Bhagavan. So this is God in sannyasi form. So the Lord has accepted sannyas so that he can actually bless all humanity and he can give everyone the highest benediction. Kalite ye yuga dharma bujayite taramarma kashi mishra gare adhisthan. So the Lord has come as Lord Chaitanya in order to bless the human race and to teach yuga dharma, the sankirtan movement, which is the essence of all religion. And this Supreme Lord Chaitanya stays in Jagannath Puri in the house of Kashi Mishra. So those who have been to Gokula know that in the house of Kashi Mishra, there is one room, Gambira, where Lord Chaitanya stayed. Nija Bhakta Vrindalaye, Nija Kalpa Taruhaye, Krishna Prema Dena Sarva Jane, Nana Mate Bhakta Muke, Bhakta Kata Shuni Shuke, Jeeva Siksha Dena Suyatane, Nija Bhakta Vrindalaye. So taking his liberated devotees with him, Kalpa Vriksha Nija Kalpa Taru Hoye. So the Lord became like a desire fulfilling tree, Kalpa Vriksha, along with all his associates. And what did he teach? Nana Matte Bhakta Muke, Bhakta Kata Shuni Suke. So he taught everyone the science of love of Krishna. And the Supreme Lord Chaitanya heard from his devotees. So we were discussing that in the Gita, Krishna speaks, Arjuna hears. But here in the avatar of Lord Chaitanya, the role reverses. In many places in Chaitanya Charitamrita and in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya is hearing and the devotees are speaking. He happily heard the science of devotion from the mouths of many different devotees and he carefully taught the conditioned souls. So Lord very carefully heard it from all various devotees, the science of bhakti, and he taught it to the conditioned souls. So in the footnote, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes, from Sri Ramananda's mouth came the description of the rasas. So here it says, Nana Mate Bhakta Muke Bhakta Kata Shuni Suke. Lord Chaitanya heard from the mouth of devotees the science of bhakti. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes that from the mouth of Ramananda Rai came the description of rasa in Kovur, in the banks of Godavari. Ramananda Rai is describing Lord Chaitanya the different types of rasas. From Sri Sarvabhauma's mouth came the description of liberation. So we know that when Lord Chaitanya took sannyas and he came to Jagannath Puri, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya taught him the entire science of mukti, the Vedanta Sutras, and Lord Chaitanya heard it very attentively. From Sri Rupa Goswami's mouth came the analysis of different rasas. And we know that Rupa Goswami compiled the science of different rasas in detail in the form of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And from Sri Haridasa's mouth came the glories of the holy name. And similarly, in this particular book, we see that Lord Chaitanya is asking Haridas Thakur and Haridas Thakur is revealing the glories of the holy name. Eka dina Bhagavan samudre kariya snan Shri Siddha Bakule Haridase Mili Anandita Mane Jignashila Sayatane Kishe Jeeva Tare Anayase. So one day, Eka Dina, that Supreme Lord, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Samudre Kariya Snan, he took bath in the ocean and Shri Siddha Bakule Haridase Milila Anandita Mane. After he took bath in the ocean, he came and met Haridas Thakur at Siddha Bakul. So this would be like the daily affair of Lord Chaitanya. He would go and have darshan of Jagannath, go to Samudra, the ocean, take bath and come and meet Haridas Thakur. So in this particular day, Lord Chaitanya asked Haridas Thakur a question. What is the question? Jigyasila Sayyatane किशे जीव तार अनायासे, हाउ विल द कंडीशन सोल्स बी इजिली डिलीवर्ड. सो लॉर्ड इज आस्किंग हरिदास ठाकुर, हाउ विल द कंडीशन सोल्स गेट डिलीवर्ड वेरी इजिली. प्रभुर चरण धरी अनेक विनय करी, गलत अश्रु फुलक शरीर, हरिदास महाशय कांदीते कांदीते कहे, प्रभु तव लीला शुभ सुगभीर. वीपिंग एंड वीपिंग, व्हेन लॉर्ड चैतन्य इज आस्किंग हरिदास ठाकुर, प्लीज टेल मी हाउ विल द कंडीशन सोल्स गेट डिलीवर्ड, हरिदास ठाकुर फॉल्स एट द फीट ऑफ लॉर्ड चैतन्य एंड क्राइंग ही इज टेलिंग द लॉर्ड, oh my dear master, your pastimes are very deep. Weeping and weeping and the hair of his body erect and humbly grasping the Lord's feet, saintly Haridas Thakur said, oh master, your pastimes are very deep. Because here, even though the Lord knows all the answers, he wants these answers to come from the mouth of Haridas Thakur. So this is the humility of Haridas Thakur. Even though he is a Namacharya, he is still so very humble. आमी अति अकिंचन नाही मोर विद्याधन, तव पद अमार संबल, एयेन अयोग्य जने प्रश्न करी अकारने, बल प्रभु हबे किब फल. ओ माय डियर मास्टर, आमी अति अकिंचन, आई एम वेरी पुअर, नाही मोर विद्याधन, आई हैव नो वेल्थ ऑफ नॉलेज ऑल्सो. So Haridas Thakur is saying, I am very poor, I have no wealth of knowledge. Your feet are my only wealth. Tava pada amara sambal. Your feet is everything for me. Ye ye he he na ayogya jane prashna kari akarane. Oh master, what is the use of asking such a question to this unfit person? Tumi Krishna swayam prabhu jiva udharite vibhu navadipe dame avatar. कृपा करी रंगा पाय राका मोरे गौर राय तबे चित्त प्रफुल्ल अमार. यू आर द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण, तुम्ही कृष्ण स्वयं प्रभु, यू आर द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड एंड यू हैव कम टू डिलीवर द कंडीशन सोल्स. जीव उद्धारिते विभु नवद्वीप धामे अवतार. सो यू आर द सेम कृष्ण, कृष्ण वर्णम तुसा कृष्णम, द सेम कृष्ण हैज कम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लॉर्ड चैतन्य and taken birth in Navadvip to deliver the conditioned souls. Kripa kari ranga paya raka mora gaura raya taba chitte prafulla amar. Oh my dear Lord, please be merciful to me, be kind to me. Oh Lord Gaura, please protect me. Please make my heart blossom with happiness. Tomara ananta nama tamananta guna grama tava rupa sukera sagar अनंत तोमार लीला कृपा करी प्रकाशीला ताई आश्वादये ए पमार. योर नेम्स हैव नो एंड, तोमार अनंत नाम, द लॉर्ड्स नेम्स आर अनलिमिटेड, तवा अनंत गुण ग्राम एंड योर ट्रांसेंडेंटल क्वालिटीज आल्सो हैव नो एंड. तव रूप सुकेर सागर, योर फॉर्म इज द ओशन ऑफ ब्लिस. अनंत तोमार लीला, your pastimes have no end. Haridas is saying that the names of the Lord are unlimited, unlimited names, the qualities of the Lord are unlimited and even the pastimes of the Lord are unlimited. Ananta tumara lila kripa kari prakashila tai ashwadaye ye pamar. Please be merciful and allow the sinner to relish the sweetness in them. So Haridas Thakur is saying, oh Lord, you are an ocean of bliss and all your pastimes, qualities, names are unlimited. Please allow me to experience a little sweetness. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in the footnote, you mercifully manifested your spiritual name, form, qualities and pastimes in this dull material world. So we discussed this in the, I think this was the foreword by Sachinandan Swami, where he explains that in this material world, the name of Krishna and the forms of Krishna, qualities of Krishna are actually spiritual. Even though this material world is a dull, inert place, this is the only dynamic force. Please allow the conditioned souls like me to relish the sweetness in them. Atha Shri Krishna Namadi Nabhave Grayam Indriyai सेवन मुखे ही जीवादो स्वयं एव स्फुरद्यत. सो द स्क्रिप्चर्स एक्सप्लेन दैट द नेम ऑफ कृष्णा अत श्री कृष्ण नामादि द नेम क्वालिटीज फॉर्म एक्सेट्रा न भवेद ग्राह्यम इंद्रियै. वन कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड विथ वन्स मटीरियल सेंसेस. सो विथ आवर मटीरियल सेंसेस वी एक्चुअली कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड दी नेम्स क्वालिटीज लीलाज ऑफ कृष्णा. बट देन सेवन मुखे ही जीवादो. But when one has that service attitude, then one can understand. So here, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, please allow the conditioned soul to relish the sweetness in them. With their material body and material senses, the conditioned souls cannot perceive Krishna's name, form, qualities, and pastimes, which are all made of pure goodness. So with our material body and material senses, we cannot perceive Krishna. Krishna, that's why Krishna is called Adokshaja, is beyond our sense perception. So only when the Lord becomes merciful to us, we can actually understand the name, form and pastimes of Krishna. By Lord Krishna's mercy, these are all manifested in the material world to bring auspiciousness to the conditioned souls. So it is only by the mercy of Krishna that these things, the form, name, pastimes of Krishna, are available for all of us. So this is a great mercy of the Lord for all of us. Because they are spiritual in nature, they are all self-manifest. We'll continue. Chinmayi Bhaskara Tumi Kirena Kana Ami Tumi Prabhu Ami Nitya Das Charana Piyusha Tava Mama Sukha Suvaibhava तव नामामृत मोर आश चिन्मय भास्कर तुमि. हरिदास इज सेइंग ओ लॉर्ड यू आर लाइक दैट स्पिरिचुअल सन नाम चिंतामणि कृष्ण चैतन्य रस विग्रह. ओ माय डियर लॉर्ड यू आर लाइक दैट स्पिरिचुअल सन एंड आई एम लाइक दैट इनसिग्निफिकेंट रे किरणेर कण आमी. ओ लॉर्ड यू आर दैट विभू एंड आई एम अनु. तुमि प्रभु आमी नित्य दास. O Lord, you are the master and I am your eternal servant. Jivera swarup hoy krishnera nitya das. We are eternal servants of Krishna. Charana piyusha tava mama sukha suvaibhava. The nectar of your feet are my wealth of pleasure. Charana piyusha. Piyusha means nectar. So the nectar of Krishna's feet is our only wealth. Mama sukha suvaibhava. Tava nama amrita mora ash. And the nectar of your holy names is my only hope. Our only hope and aspiration for devotees is to taste the nectar of Krishna's holy name. E mata adamma ami ki balite jani swami taba agyana kariba palan ya balaba mora muke tumara balibe suke dosha guna na kari ganan. ओ मास्टर आई एम फॉलन ए मत अदम आमी की बलिते जानी स्वामी. हाउ विल आई नो व्हाट टू से. ओ माय डियर लॉर्ड यू आर टेस्टिंग मी, यू आर आस्किंग मी टू स्पीक दीज थिंग्स बट आई एम सो फॉलन. हाउ विल आई नो व्हाट टू से. स्टिल आई मस्ट ओबे योर कमांड तब आज्ञा करीब पालन. इवन तो आई एम अनक्वालिफाइड माय क्वालिफिकेशन इज आई विल फॉलो योर कमांड. करिष्ये वचनम तव. या बालाभ मोरा मुके तुमारे बलीबे सुके दोष गुण न करी गणन. द वर्ड्स यू प्लेस इन माय माउथ आई विल हैप्पीली स्पीक. सो रामानंद राय आल्सो एक्चुअली सेज दिस. द सेम मूड डिवोटीज हैव. लॉर्ड आई एम लाइक अ पपेट. दिस टंग इज लाइक अ पपेट एंड यू आर कंट्रोलिंग द स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ दिस टंग. सो वॉट एवर वर्ड्स यू प्लेस इन माय माउथ आई विल स्पीक. सो यू आर एक्चुअली आस्किंग मी टू स्पीक बट अल्टीमेटली यू आर ओनली going to make me speak. I will not try to judge their virtues or faults. Haridas is saying, whatever inspiration you give, I will speak. So I'm not going to judge whether what I'm speaking is right or wrong, because whatever inspiration comes is coming from you only. So now Haridas, from this point, is actually going to speak about the glories of the holy name. So this first section is called Krishna Tattva. The truth of Lord Krishna. Ekamatra Ichchamaya Krishna Sarveshwara नित्य शक्ति योगे कृष्ण विभु परात्पर. सो लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड है. देर इज नो अदर. एकमात्र इच्छामय कृष्ण सर्वेश्वर. सो बिफोर गेटिंग इन टू द नेम्स ऑफ होली नेम्स ऑफ कृष्णा, हरिदास ठाकुर इज वेरी सिस्टमैटिकली बिल्डिंग फर्स्ट टू मेक ऑल ऑफ अस अंडरस्टैंड कृष्ण तत्व. सो ही इज सेइंग कृष्णा इज द ओनली मास्टर, देर इज नो अदर. एकमात्र एकेले ईश्वर कृष्ण आर सब भृत्य. सो द ओनली मास्टर इज कृष्णा, रेस्ट ऑल आर सर्वेंट्स. लाइक ब्रह्मा सरिता ब्रह्माजी एक्सप्लेन्स ईश्वर परम कृष्ण. दे मे बी मेनी अदर ईश्वर्स बट द सुप्रीम इज कृष्णा, देर इज नो अदर. नित्य शक्ति योगे कृष्ण विभु परात्पर. हिज एवरी डिजायर इज ऑलवेज फुलफिल्ड. सो फर्स्ट इज कृष्णा इज द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड. There is no other like Krishna. He is the only one. His every desire is fulfilled. He is eternal. He is the master of all potencies. He is the greater. He is greater than the greatest. He is Vibhu. And through all his energies, all his desires are fulfilled. Just like the Bible says, na, God desired, let there be creation, and there was creation. So just by his desiring, everything just works automatically. So that is the greatness of Krishna. So then he explains, sorry, there's a footnote here. Lord Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. He is supremely independent. So Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. Janmadi yasti yataha. And Krishna is Swarat. He is fully, supremely independent. No one can control Krishna. No one can tell Krishna, this is what you have to do. No. No one can dictate anything to Krishna. His desires are always fulfilled. He is Atma Ram. He possesses inconceivable potencies. So the Lord has unlimited inconceivable potencies. Achintya Shakti. He is supremely conscious. You know, and he is a living person with consciousness. Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. Chaitanya means living force. He possesses potencies. Nothing is independent of him. Everything ultimately depends on Krishna. His potencies are his glories and powers. So the potencies of the Lord, the Shakti of the Lord, are the glories of the Lord. Just like a powerful king or a powerful minister has many, many people under him. The more people you have under him, under you, the more powerful you are. Similarly, the glories of Krishna is that he has unlimited potencies and unlimited powers. His powers and glories are limitless. There is no limit to the glories and powers of Krishna. Lord Krishna is the one non-dual supreme truth. Non-dual means there cannot be any second version of Krishna. Just that one Lord. The impersonalists see Krishna as the undivided, qualityless Brahman. The truth is that the Brahman is the effulgence of Lord Krishna's body. So those who are Nirvisheshavadi, Brahmavadi, they think that the supreme is Brahman, the energy aspect. But we all know that Brahman effulgence comes from the body of Krishna. Brahmanohi pratishtaham. So the truth is that the Brahman is the effulgence of Lord Krishna's body. The followers of Ashtanga Yoga see Krishna as the all-pervading, subtle, super soul present everywhere in the universes and in the heart of all. So there are these three categories of people. One is the Jnanis. The Jnanis want to merge into Brahman. Their goal is Brahman. The Yogis, their goal is Paramatma. Paramatma realization. And the devotees, Bhaktas, their goal is Bhagavan. But we all know that among all three, the supreme is Bhagavan. It's all inclusive. Just like you have a 1,000 rupee note. In that 1,000 rupee note, there is 10 rupee note, 100 rupee note, like that. So if anyone surrenders to Bhagavan, automatically the Brahman feature, the Paramatma feature is realized automatically. No separate endeavor is required. Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayati Ashu Vairagyam Jnanam Chayat Ahetukam. So the Bhagavatam explains the first canto. When someone does Bhakti, Jnana Vairagya and everything else naturally follow. So what the yogis and the gyanis are going to get, the devotees get much beyond that. So that's what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining, that those who aim for Brahman, they don't understand that the Brahman is actually just an effulgence of Krishna's body. And those who aim for Paramatma, they don't understand that that Paramatma feature is only an amsh, only a part and parcel of Krishna. We know that, you know, from Krishna, Balaramji comes. From Balaramji, there is that quadruple incarnation, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna, Aniruddha. From that Sankarshan, there is secondary Sankarshan. Then Mahavishnu, Garbhodakshay Vishnu, and then Shirodakshay Vishnu, which is the Paramatma. Imagine Krishna's position. So the Adi Leela of Chaitanya Charitamrita explains the glory of Krishna. So before, so Haridas Thakur is very systematic. Even though Haridas Thakur chants throughout the day, throughout the night, 192 rounds, but see his understanding. You know, so in order to chant Hare Krishna also, we need to have an understanding properly, the tattva properly. In order to appreciate the holy name, first we should understand who that Krishna is. So that Krishna is the Supreme Lord from whom Brahman and Paramatma also emanate. The followers of Ashtanga Yoga see Krishna as the all-pervading subtle super soul present everywhere in the universe and in the hearts of all. In truth, Lord Krishna does not manifest himself in an Amsha avatar as the super soul. Therefore, Brahman and Paramatma are both partial manifestations of Lord Krishna. These are just partial manifestations, not the full manifestation. Power is limited. Just like, you know, you have like a high power grid, you know, from where power comes, there'll be a little bulb. That bulb doesn't need that entire power. If it gives too much power, the bulb will explode. It has that limited power. How much light is needed, that much only it will give. Similarly, the various avatars of the Lord, the Paramatma feature, the Brahman, or the other various avatars, Rama, Narasimha, they have limited power. They come at a particular time to give limited light. But Krishna is that Supreme Lord. Like in the Bhagavatam, when in the first canto, when the list of all the incarnations is given, the shloka ends with Etesha Amshakala Pumsa Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. All these avatars are Amsha or Kala, part or part of the part. But Krishna is that Supreme Lord. Therefore, Brahman and Paramatma are both partial manifestations of Lord Krishna. Therefore, Krishna has all desires and all powers. He is fully conscious of everything. He is the independent supreme person. So Krishna is that supreme independent person on whom everything depends. Sarva karana karanam. So then Haridas Thakur explains, he's explained now Krishna Tattva, how Krishna is that supreme person of Godhead, whose every desire is fulfilled, who has unlimited potencies. No one is greater than him. He is greater than the greatest. And now he explains Krishna and Krishna Shakti, Lord Krishna and his potencies. Krishna Shakti Krishna Haite Nahaya Swatantra E Shakti Sei Krishna Kahe Veda Mantra. Krishna Shakti Krishna Haite Nahaya Swatantra. The potencies are never independent of Lord Krishna. So the Shaktis of Krishna are not independent of him. They are always dependent on Krishna. Lord Krishna is identical with his potencies. E Shakti Sei Krishna Kahe Veda Mantra. This is the Vedic mantras, what they say. That means this is the Achintya Veda, Veda Tattva. That Krishna and his energies are simultaneously one and still different. Krishna Vibhu Shakti Tara Vaibhava Swarupa Ananta Vaibhava Krishna Haya Eka Rupa. Krishna Vibhu, Lord Krishna is the all-powerful. His potencies are his powers and glories. Lord Krishna is one power, one person. His glories and powers have no end. So just like Krishna is also unlimited, similarly, the energies and powers of Krishna are also unlimited. Naam naam kari bahudha nija sarva shaktis. So Lord Chaitanya says that, O Lord, you have many names and you have invested all your powers in the holy names. So what are the three kinds of potencies of Krishna? So he's explained Krishna Tattva. He's given an idea of Krishna potencies, that there are various kinds of energies of Krishna. Principally explains there are three kinds of energies. Trividha Vaibhava, three kinds of potencies. Shaktira Prakasha Ei Saita Vaibhava, Vibhura Vaibhava Matra Haya Anubhava. His potencies manifest his powers and glories. Those powers and glories enable us to see him. So the Lord expands himself into various energies, and through those energies we can actually appreciate the Lord. So what are the three kinds of potencies? Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in the footnote, Lord Krishna's powers and glories are of three kinds. Principally three kinds of energy: spirit, matter or his maya potency, and the individual spirit souls. You know, Bahiranga Shakti, Antaranga Shakti, Tatastha Shakti. The spirit, the internal potency, maya, which is the external potency, and the jiva, the individual spirit souls. Vaibhava Trividha Tava Gauranga Sundar Chid Achid Jiva Tina Shastrera Gochar. Lord Chaitanya has three kinds of powers and glories. The Supreme Lord Krishna, Lord Chaitanya, has three kinds of powers. They are spirit, chid, the spiritual power, achid, which is the material power, and jiva, living entities. Tina Shastrera Gochar. This is what the scriptures say. So then now Haridas Thakur goes to explain the spiritual power, the internal potency, chid vaibhava, his spiritual powers. Ananta Vaikunta Adi Yata Krishna Dham Govinda Shri Krishna Hari Adi Yata Nam. So what comes under the spiritual power? The limitless realms that begin with Vaikunta are Lord Krishna's abode. Ananta Vaikunta Adi Yata Krishna Dham. So they are unlimited Vaikunta Loka. You can't even count how many planets are there in the Vaikunta Loka. In the material world only, the scriptures explain that if you have like a sack of mustard seed, no mustard seed, rai ka dana, itna chota hota hai. In one handful only, you will not be able to count how many mustard seed is there. Imagine a sack of mustard seed. Can you count how many are there? That many universes are there in this world. And this material world is just one fraction of Krishna's creation. The rest is the spiritual world. Imagine how many Vaikuntha planets. I mean, we had gone for a Tamil Nadu trip. And there are so many holy places there. Going to those holy places only, you get tired. No end only. This here, one place, so many places. Imagine going to Vaikuntha Loka and seeing all. Unlimited, you'll never come to an end. So in the chit power, in the spiritual power, limitless realms that begin with Vaikuntha Loka are Lord Krishna's abode. The names that begin with Govinda, Shri Krishna and Hari are his names. So the spiritual potency contains the holy abode, the holy names, everything come under the internal potency. Dvija, Dvibhuja, Muralidhara, Adi Yata Rupa, Bhaktananda Prada Adi, Guna Aparupa. His forms begin with his two-armed form where he plays the flute. His wonderful qualities begin with his quality of giving bliss to his devotees. So, what all come under spiritual power? Haridas Thakur has explained the dham, the abode of the Lord, Vaikuntha, beginning with Vaikuntha till Golok Vrindavan, everything comes under the spiritual potency. Then the names of Krishna, Govinda, Shri Krishna, Hari, and you can keep going on and on. All of them come under the spiritual power. Then the forms of Krishna, Dvibhuja, Muralidhara, Adi Yataru, unlimited forms of the Lord, they come under spiritual power. And Bhaktananda Prada Adi Guna Aparupa, and all the wonderful qualities. So Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela and Dhamma, all of them come under the spiritual potency. Vraje Rasa Leela Navadvipe Sankirtana Ei Rupa Krishna Leela Vichitra Ganana. In Vraja, he enjoys the pastimes of rasa dance. In Navadvip, he enjoys the pastimes of Sankirtan. Lord Krishna's wonderful pastimes are like these. So the Leelas also come under the spiritual potency. So in Vrindavan, Krishna is doing Ras Leela, and the same Krishna of Vrindavan comes in Navadvip. So Navadvip and Vrindavan are like two rooms, you know, replicas basically, but the moods are different. So Krishna is doing Ras Leela in Vrindavan, and in Navadvip, the same Krishna comes as Lord Chaitanya, and the Ras Leela becomes Sankirtan. So the Ras Tali in Vrindavan becomes the Shriva Sangan in Navadvip Leela. So what we are actually getting to participate, the Sankirtan movement of Lord Chaitanya is actually non-different than the Ras Leela of Krishna. That's what we are given entry to. So in this way, Lord Krishna's Leelas goes on. ए समस्त चित वैभव अपराकृत हय आसीयो ये प्रपंच प्रापंचिक नय. All of his spiritual powers and glories are not material. ए समस्त चित वैभव. So all these spiritual powers of Krishna, what all come under spiritual powers? You can recap. The first is, what did Gajraj Thakur explain? Dham. All the holy abodes of the Lord, Vaikuntha, everything comes under the spiritual power. Second is the names of Krishna. The third is the forms of Krishna, the various deities of Krishna. Even in this world, Balaji, Jagannath, whatever, all the forms of Krishna. Then the qualities of Krishna. And the fifth is the Leelas of Krishna. So all of his spiritual powers and glories are not material. Ye samasta chit vaibhava aprakrakrita haya. They are not material. Asiyo ye prapancha prapanchika naya. Even though they are manifested in the material world. Prapancha means the material world. Even though they are manifested in the material world, prapanchika naya. They are not material themselves. So Haridas Thakur is explaining that spiritual powers, that even though the name of Krishna may appear to be material, the forms of Krishna, the deities of Krishna may appear to be material, like Jagannath made of wood, they may appear to be material forms, the pastimes may appear material, the dham may appear material to us, but we should understand that even though they are material world, asiyo ye prapancha prapanchika naya, even though they are in the material world, they are not material. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in the footnote, Lord Krishna's spiritual powers and glories are counted among his spiritual potencies. So Krishna's spiritual powers, glories and shaktis are counted as antaranga shakti. Lord Krishna's spiritual potency is his superior potency. So among the three, inferior, marginal, superior. The superior potency is the spiritual potency, the internal potency. His perfect spiritual potency manifests his spiritual powers and glories. From Lord Krishna's spiritual potencies are manifest his spiritual abode, his spiritual holy name, spiritual form, and multitude of spiritual pastimes. So from the internal potency comes the abode of the Lord, which is spiritual, the name of the Lord, which is spiritual, the form of the Lord, the qualities of the Lord, everything is spiritual. These are his spiritual powers and glories. So this is the glories of Krishna's spiritual power, internal potency. From his spiritual sandini potency is manifest eternal spiritual existence. So we know this also, that the internal potency is made of three aspects. Sandini, samvit, ladini. So from the sandini potency is all the dham. The spiritual existence is there. From his samvit potency manifests spiritual knowledge. So from the sandini potency, well, technical, but then if we can understand it, our chanting of the holy name will become better. So initially we may not understand the connection. How has all these technical things to do with chanting Hare Krishna? But there is a deep science behind it. Otherwise, Haridas Thakur will simply just say, chant Hare Krishna. But he is actually getting into these details to tell us that if you understand this properly, we will be able to appreciate chanting better. So the sandini potency of the Lord, which is one of the aspects of the internal potency, is existence. The dham and everything is existence because of the sandini potency. And the samvit potency is manifest in spiritual knowledge. So whatever spiritual knowledge we have, the Gita, the Bhagavatam, is manifestation of samvit potency. And from this Ladini potency manifests spiritual bliss. So any bliss that someone experiences in the process of bhakti is because of the Ladini Shakti. Relationships and rasa are manifest from these. So all the rasas and relationships are manifest from these internal potency. Yoga Maya is counted among the spiritual potencies. Yoga Maya is beyond material place, time and qualities. It is always pure and blissful. So the material Maya is called Mahamaya, and the spiritual energy of Krishna is called Yoga Maya. Chid Vyapara Samudra Vishnu Tattva Sar Vishnu Pada Vali Vede Gaya Varavar. Lord Krishna's power and glories are Lord Krishna himself. Chid Vyapara Samudya Vishnu Tattva Sar. So the glories of Krishna, the powers of Krishna are the Lord himself. So that means Nama Namino Abhinnatvam. This is our understanding, that the names of Krishna, which is actually one of the energies of the Lord, the names, is non-different than the Lord. Similarly, the Dham of the Lord is also non-different than the Lord. The deities of the Lord are also non-different than the Lord. Vishnu Pada Bali Veda Gaya Bar Bar. Again and again, Vedas use the word Vishnu Pada to describe these powers and glories. Lord Vishnu himself or Lord Vishnu's lotus feet. So the power and glories of the Lord are also called Vishnu Pada. So then he explains, Lord Krishna's spiritual powers and glories are situated in pure goodness. They are Lord Krishna himself. So till now he has explained what are the various aspects that come under spiritual power. Now he explains how the spiritual powers of the Lord are pure goodness. They are Shuddha Sattva, not part of the material plane. And they are Lord Krishna himself, identical to him. Krishnera Chit Vibhuti A Vishnu Tattva Shuddha Sattva. It's as good as Vishnu Tattva, the energies of the Lord, the internal potency, and it is Shuddha Sattva. It is not even material goodness. Nahi Tahe Jada Dharma Mayara Vikar Jada Dita Vishnu Tattva Shuddha Sattva Sar. Lord Krishna, Vishnu Tattva, is not a transformation of matter. Nahi tahe jada dharma mayara vikar. So the deity, we should not think that it is transformation of material things. No, it is not part of the material realm. Even when Krishna was personally present, most people were thinking that Krishna is an ordinary material form Krishna has. He is like all of us. So Krishna tells in the Gita, so such people who think me to be an ordinary human being, they are actually fools. They have not understood. So that's why Haridas Thakur is saying here, Nahi tahe jada dharma mayara vikar. So the Vishnu Tattva is not transformation of matter. Jada tita Vishnu Tattva Shuddha Sattva Sar. He is situated in pure goodness, Shuddha Sattva. He is beyond matter. Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto Abhinnatvam Nama Nameno. So the names of Krishna are fully pure. Purna Shuddho. That means not material goodness. Shuddha Sattva, pure goodness. And Nitya Mukto, always liberated. So the Vishnu Tattva and the spiritual powers of Krishna are not part of the material world. Shuddha Sattva Rajas Tamo Gandha Virahita Rajas Tamo Mishra Mishra Sattva Suvigita. Pure spirit Shuddha Sattva is not mixed with even the slightest tinge of the mode of passion. Goodness mixed with passion or ignorance is called Mishra Sattva, mixed goodness. So the goodness in this world is also not pure goodness, because in this world anything that is there is always mixed with impurities, with either passion or ignorance. But Krishna, Vishnu Tattva, and the energies of Krishna, the spiritual energies of Krishna, are Shuddha Sattva. They are not mixed even with the slightest tinge of the mode of passion. So there is Shuddha Sattva and Mishra Sattva. When it is mixed, Shuddha Sattva is pure goodness, spiritual goodness. And mixed means mixed with material elements. passion and ignorance. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes an elaborate footnote here. Goodness is of two kinds, pure goodness and mixed goodness. Two types of goodness, pure and mixed. Okay, so we'll do till here and then we'll recap what we have done till here. Okay, and when we come next time also, we'll do a quick recap. So the book is like this. It gets a little interesting later, but there's a lot of technical subjects. And if you can really understand this, you will be able to appreciate many other books also. You know, so this is like the essence of all the teachings of our Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. So we'll be able to better appreciate Gita, Bhagavatam and everything. So it appears to be a little difficult, but actually it's quite simple. You know, if you can put it in the form of flowcharts, you'll understand that it's in one go, you'll understand the whole chapter. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes in the footnote, goodness is of two kinds. Pure goodness, mixed goodness. Pure goodness is called what? Shuddha Sattva. Mixed goodness is called Mishra Sattva. All goodness in the Lord's spiritual powers and glories are pure goodness. So what we are discussing till now? We are discussing the internal potency, the spiritual power. So all the goodness in Lord's spiritual powers and glories are Shuddha Sattva. The name, form, qualities, leela, dham, everything is pure goodness. All goodness in the dull material world is mixed goodness. So all the goodness sattva that is there connecting to Krishna and Krishna's internal potency is all Shuddha Sattva. And if there is goodness in the material world, it is all mixed, Mishra Sattva. In pure goodness, passion and ignorance are not present. From passion comes birth. Spiritual existence is beginningless and has no passion, which would bring birth and beginnings. So in pure goodness, Shuddha Sattva, there is no passion and ignorance. Because if there is passion, passion means creation. Right? That's why Brahmadi is a guna avatar for passion. Because passion means birth and creation. The act of birth happens because of passion, raja. So spiritual existence, spiritual life means no beginning and no birth. Right? There is no beginning. That is spiritual, right? Na jayate mriyate va kadachin. There is no death and there is no even birth for the spirit soul. So if there is birth, if there is a beginning, that means it is mixed goodness, not pure goodness. Spiritual existence has no ignorance either. Ignorance brings death and destruction. So passion means birth and a beginning. Ignorance means death and destruction. Shivji is Rudra, who comes at a time of destruction. So pure goodness means no birth, no beginning, and no death, no destruction. And that is the definition of bhakti also. Bhakti rasamrita sindhu, amrita. Amrita means eternal life. So Prabhupada explains, if you have read the Nectar of Devotion, Prabhupada explains that in this world, there are two kinds of rasa. Bhakti rasa and mundane rasa. So mundane rasa has a beginning as an end. Rasa, you can translate it as juice or relationship, whatever. So in this world, every relationship has a beginning, has an end. Correct? Antamantu imetesham. But in bhakti rasa, it has no beginning and it has no end also. It is eternal. Right? So that is the spiritual power. No beginning, no end. Like Krishna's forms. So Krishna's form have no beginning, no end. Krishna's dham are eternal. The principle of eternity means no beginning, no end. Krishna's qualities, Krishna's leelas, no beginning, no end. Ignorance brings death and destruction. Therefore, absent of passion and ignorance, spiritual existence is characterized as an eternal present, nitya vartaman. So, spiritual life means no passion, no ignorance. Na shochati, na kankshati. Brahma bhuta prasannatma. no past, no future, only eternally present, nitya vartaman, eternally present, you know. So this is spiritual life about, you know, being eternally present in Shuddha Sattva. The supreme lords, Amsha avatars, who are all non-different from him, are always situated in pure goodness. So the names of Krishna, the dham of Krishna, the form, the avatars of the Lord are all situated in pure goodness. That means they are all eternal. So when someone asks this question, before Krishna was born 5,000 years before that there was no Krishna. No, understanding is wrong. Krishna means eternal. Anything connected to Krishna is spiritual, is eternal. No beginning, no end. The touch of Maya makes goodness become mixed with passion and ignorance. So when someone comes in touch with Maya, even if someone is pure goodness, as soon as you come in touch with Maya, contamination comes. So that is why it is explained that the difference between Vishnu and Shiva, in one sense, both are the same only. Like Brahma Samhita explains that example of the milk and the curd. So in one sense, milk and curd are same. Correct. If you ask someone, is milk and curd same? Answer is yes, they are same. But still the answer is no, because when milk comes in touch with a sour element, it becomes curd. So when Vishnu has to come in touch with Maya, Vishnu doesn't touch Maya. Vishnu transforms into Shiva and Shiva comes in contact with Parvati or Maya. That's how creation takes place, right? So Vishnu doesn't come in touch with Maya, never. Because as soon as you touch Maya, that goodness becomes mixed. So that is why Lord Shiva is not Shuddha Sattva. The Vishnu Tattvas are Shuddha Sattva. Shiva is not fully goodness because he has come in touch with Maya. The touch of Maya makes goodness become mixed with passion and ignorance. Shiva and the demigods are more virtuous than the conditioned souls. So Shiva and the demigods are much more better than the conditioned souls. That's for sure. Their level of goodness is far higher. Proud of their superiority, the demigods have goodness that is considered mixed with passion and ignorance. Even though their goodness quantity is very high compared to the conditioned souls, but there is a slight tinge of passion and ignorance, not 100% pure. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, however, is situated in pure goodness. So only Vishnu and Vishnu Tattva are situated in pure Shuddha Sattva. When employing his inconceivable potencies, he descends to the material world. He always remains in pure goodness. So even though the Lord comes to the material world, still he doesn't get in touch with that material world. He's still aloof. He's always Shuddha Sattva. He always remains the master of Maya. Maya always follows his command. So even when he comes to the material world, he is always the master of Maya. Maya dakshena prakriti suyate sa characharam. So Krishna says, under my direction, prakriti works. Just like we know in the in Krishna Leela, before Krishna descends, Balaram ji is there in Devaki's womb. So Krishna tells Yoga Maya that take Balaram ji away. And then that Yoga Maya, when Kamsa brings this child back, she takes the form of Durga to tell Kamsa that you are worshipping me, but my master is already born somewhere else. So Durga Devi, Maya Devi, eternally follows the command of Krishna. Maya always follows his command. Like Brahma Samhita explained, just like a shadow follows a person continuously, and the shadow is always at the back, not in the front, you know, always following the person. Similarly, Maya Devi continuously follows Krishna's will. So that is the power of Krishna. So we will continue. We went quite longer. Sorry, I lost track of time. Okay. So we'll continue from this point the next time. So let's like quickly recap what we saw till here. And then the next time also we'll recap. So we started with explaining how one time Lord Chaitanya comes and meets Haridas Thakur in Siddha Bakul, and he's asking Haridas Thakur this question that, please tell me, how will the conditioned souls be delivered? And Haridas Thakur very humbly falls at the feet of Lord Chaitanya, weeping, and he cries and tells that, this is your Leela. You are that Supreme Lord. Your pastimes are unlimited. You are full of bliss. And I am an insignificant servant. How can I speak something? I am completely foolish. I don't have any knowledge. How can I speak something? But still, because it is your command, I will try. I will do my duty of speaking. And you will put the right words in my mouth. So then Haridas Thakur explains Krishna Tattva, saying that how Lord Krishna is that one Supreme Lord without a second. He has unlimited potencies. He is greater than the greatest. He is eternal. And then he explains the Lord and his potencies. The Vedic mantras say that the Lord is non-different than his potencies. And the Lord has unlimited potencies, but principally three. Three with the vaibhav, three kinds of potencies. And the three are chid, achid, jiva. Spiritual potency, material potency, and the living entity. So then, today what we saw was part of the spiritual potency, the chit potency. So we saw what all come under chit potency: the dham of the Lord, the names of the Lord, the form of the Lord, pastimes, qualities. These all come under the spiritual potency. And the Vedas say that even though these spiritual potencies manifest in the material world, they are not part of the material world. Asiyo ye prapanche prapanchika naya. Even though they appear in this prapancha, they are not part of the material world. So people who are foolish, they say that Vishnu Tattva is the transformation of matter. But this is where he comes to the next point to explain that how Lord Krishna and his powers, spiritual powers, are all Shuddha Sattva. They cannot be transformation of matter. And Shuddha Sattva means where there is no passion, no ignorance, full goodness, pure goodness. So, and we ended with this, and we read the footnote where Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that there are these two kinds of goodness, pure and mixed. All the demigods, they may have high level of goodness, but there is some mixture of passion and ignorance. But Krishna and the Vishnu Tattva, Krishna's form, Leela, pastimes, names, they are fully pure goodness. They have no mixture of passion and ignorance. So therefore, Krishna's name qualities are fully pure. Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto. So this is where we ended, page 25. So we'll continue from here the next time. Anyone has any questions? Was it okay?
Hare Krishna Guruji, Dandavat Pranam.
Yes, Guru, Dandavat.
Guruji, जो आपने बताया जैसे विष्णु तत्व है तो शुद्ध मतलब सत्य हो गए और जो शिव है वो तामसिक जो अपना तामसिक उसमें आ गए तो जैसे आपने बताया ना पार्वती के टच में है तो फिर विष्णु के साथ जो अपनी लक्ष्मी जी है तो फिर उनमें कैसे मतलब हुआ ये थोड़ा सा समझ नहीं आ रहा क्वेश्चन समझ में आ गया प्रभु जी
हाँ क्वेश्चन समझ में आ गया तो पार्वती लक्ष्मी और पार्वती में फर्क है लक्ष्मी भगवान की अंतरंग शक्ति है पर पार्वती शी इज मटीरियल एनर्जी भौतिक शक्ति है प्रकृति है तो भगवान पार्वती भौतिक शक्ति के साथ में आते नहीं है भौतिक प्रकृति के साथ में आना है तो भगवान शिवजी बनते हैं और शिवजी पार्वती का पार्वती के साथ संग करते हैं तो कहने का मतलब है इसलिए शिवजी हालांकि विष्णु के ऑलमोस्ट ही हैं पर क्योंकि वो भौतिक माया देवी के स्पर्श में आते हैं इसलिए वो पूरे तरह से शुद्ध नहीं है तो इससे समझ में आता है कि कैसे विष्णु श्रेष्ठ है शिवजी से भी
विष्णु और शिव मतलब दोनों का मतलब कंपैरिजन है
हाँ हाँ
कृष्णा से तो कोई कंपैरिजन नहीं है ना विष्णु उनका शिव का क्योंकि वो तो फिर इसी के गर्भोदक से विष्णु के पार्ट हो गए ना वो तो
कौन
जो भी जो शिव का जो जन्म हुआ है जो ब्रह्मा हाँ, जी से हुआ है ना प्रभु जी
हाँ 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 वो एक कहानी है पर शिव जी का जो स्तर है ब्रह्मा जी से भी ज्यादा श्रेष्ठ है
ओके
तो ब्रह्मा जी का गिनती जनरली जीव तत्व में होता है पर शिव जी का गिनती अलग ही एक तत्व है शंभू तत्व करके
इसी थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन रहता है लोगों के, ये डिबेट कर देते हैं इस पे, हमें कुछ पता ही नहीं इसके बारे में, कुछ दे नहीं।
ये सब पढ़ेंगे विस्तार से तो धीरे धीरे हमको समझ में आएगा।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल जी, थैंक यू सो मच।
और किसी का कुछ प्रश्न, एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? या
Prabhuji, that Brahmaputra, something you said, no past, no future. Can you please elaborate it?
Just 1 minute, but go. What is that? Correct.
Is there any specific cause in there for two part of the
Gaurangpur was telling the story when Gaurangpur initially came in ISKCON, you know, he was in IIT hostel. So because they became devotees, they couldn't eat that mess food. So 2-3 devotees were there. So one devotee was the cook. He would cook prasad. So one day there was a big debate. The debate topic was, did man land on moon? So one devotee was saying, no, man didn't land on moon because scriptures say moon is very far, no one can land. The other person, devotee, was a cook. He was saying, no, we landed on moon. Debate chal raha hai dono ka. गोरखपुर टेंशन में आ गए क्योंकि डिबेट चलता रहेगा, प्रसाद नहीं बनेगा। तो थोड़े प्रश्नों का जो हम सुनते हैं बस उतना, बस आई रियली डोंट नो दैट आंसर ऑफ व्हाई देयर इज टू क्वाड्रुपल इंकार्नेशन, मुझे पता नहीं। बट गुड क्वेश्चन, वी कैन आस्क समवन, कावली बलराम शक्ति के ऊपर समवन। And no lamentation. Hankering is for the future. Future desires you hanker, and lamentation for the past. So because he is experiencing Brahman, or he is experiencing that spiritual bliss, he is living life in the present, living life in a very Krishna conscious way. So therefore he doesn't worry about the future, neither he laments for the past. So I mentioned that because Bhaktivinoda Thakur writes here, spiritual existence has no ignorance either. Therefore, absent of passion and ignorance, spiritual existence is characterized as an eternal present, nitya vartaman. So generally, when someone is passionate, he has lot of future desires. And when someone is ignorance, when there's a lot of ignorance, you go in depression and keep start thinking about your past. So when you are in goodness, you can actually remain in the present. So actually it's a very practical lesson for all of us also. If you want to get rid of passion and ignorance, the easiest way is to focus on the present. So while we are chanting Krishna's holy name, if you just focus on that, at least in that particular period, we will be aloof from passion and ignorance. Is it okay, Bhattu?
Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Okay. So was today's session okay? Too technical?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Dandavat Pranam. I have one question. Prabhuji, Yogmaya is called, Subhadra Maya is called Yogmaya.
Correct.
So who is Mahamaya?
Mahamaya is Parvati, that's what I told you, Durga.
So Yogmaya is a in spiritual thing.
Yeah, Yogmaya is internal.
And Mahamaya is in touch with material.
Correct.
So it is called Mahamaya.
Correct.
Haribol. 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 Thank you.
Okay. I hope you all are enjoying it.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay. Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol, Dhanut.
You all can also go through what we have done in this week so that, you know, the next time it's like more fresh. The concepts are more deeply ingrained. So we'll continue the next talk.
Yeah, pranam, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, okay, Manoj speaking.
Yeah.
Can you just upload the videos, okay, which of the previous topics which you have discussed in this particular Harinam Chintamani?
Yeah. I've been telling everyone to upload the videos.
Yeah.
We'll do it soon.
Yeah. I've missed out certain two or three parts of it.
Yeah. So we'll try to do it in this week.
Yeah.
We'll try to upload all the videos in this week.
Yeah. Okay. Hari bol, Prabhuji.
Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, that the summary you gave was very clear. So can okay. the summary could be prepared and posted in the...
Yeah, I think we should do it. Yeah. If someone can do it, it would be great. In fact, I think we should also, someone should post the summary also. And I think someone, you know, can make like a flowchart at the end of the chapter. One flowchart that explains the entire theme, basically. You know, the most important themes. So then just looking at the flowchart, it becomes clear for everyone. So if someone can do it, it's like great. I think we should do it after every class, the summary, the quick summary points, if someone can put across, and probably at the end of the chapter, if someone can show like a one quick chart, basically. So if anyone is interested, please do it. It should be very useful. So this is like a study program only, you know, it's not like a regular class thing. So the more we do these things, it'll be better. Okay. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Bol, Prabhuji.